Project Memphis, a customized Windows 10 installation to make it as close as possible to Windows 98, and we're going to check out all changes and see if it really is. Before we go to the desktop, I want to show you how the setup looks, because it's really cool. Although it displays the Windows 10 boot screen, which is not a surprise, the actual setup uses Panther 2K, which is basically a modern Windows installation app that uses classic text mode look. Very cool! It really gives the feeling of using an old version of Windows, especially the installation segment. But the thing that throws me off is that the file displayed on the copying section at the bottom right is pretty much, well, gibberish, even though it isn't. Fast forward to the second phase, it directly boots to the OS, with a command-like logon UI that replaces the Windows 10 version. After a few moments, there we go, Project Memphis is installed. Except I have to install VMware Tool first. And now we're back, and check out the startup sound. Pretty nice, right? Looking at the desktop, you can easily see the similarities between this mod and the real Windows 98. The background looks similar, as well as the icons and the taskbar, although the desktop icon spacing between each other is noticeably different, and the icon tray spacing too. But I think some of them can be solved by automatically just, well, waiting. Hey, the welcome app! Yes, this is taken from Windows 98, and I am confidently sure that this is directly taken from it. And it's not really just for decorations. You can hover over the content list, and it dynamically changes. Right, opening the start menu, and the classic variant is in here. It is surprisingly accurate to the real version, as you can see. But I don't think the accuracy stays when I check out the program list. Windhoek is listed in the maintenance folder for some reason. Startup folder is located at the top. There's Windows Administrative Tools folder, which is empty, and probably that's that. Moving to other options like Favorites, Documents, and Settings, they are pretty darn well. Except the Find option lacks the Internet and Computer options inside, unlike Windows 98. But that's a minor difference, and I can set that aside. When you open the Files and Folder options, you'll be greeted by the Search MS in the File Explorer. Yeah folks, after over 2 years of looking at mods that have the proper Search MS look, this is one of them. It just fits to Windows 9X rather than leaving it with Windows 7 appearance like in Windows 11. Unfortunately, it doesn't behave as expected. You can run basic apps in the address bar, but don't expect it to do much than that, because it's basically an address bar, not a proper search box. Moving to Windows Explorer, and yes, the appearance is 95% accurate, not 98%. The only difference is the Go button addition, as well as the drive and folders position switched up. Well, it is 95% accurate if you disable web view, as the Windows 98 sidebar thingy can't easily be replicated in Windows 10. But hey, you have all other features functioning, such as the command bar. You can navigate the back and forth, see properties, and even switch the view. Well, the issue with the views button is that it only toggles to tiles view, and you have to use the drop-down menu to manually change it. Next, control panel. Apart from several missing applets, this is a good recreation, because it utilizes a cheeky trick as you can see on the address bar. Yes, it's actually a folder inside a C drive. Aside from that, you'll essentially get the feel of Windows 98 control panel, though some applets don't match their 98 counterparts. While we're inside the control panel, check out the sound scheme. Tell us in the comments if the sound scheme is accurate enough. S4 system applications, we have Internet Explorer. And don't look at the yellow bar, as it's a spoiler of what I'm about to say. The Internet Explorer automatically opens up MSN Mexico, because the creator of this mod, Mr. Amayoskin, is from Mexico. Hola, mi nombre es Philip, soy tu querido amigo. There you go for your Spanish-speaking viewers. This browser can actually navigate to modern websites such as YouTube. Hey, my YouTube channel! Make sure to subscribe as I am going to reach 10,000 subscribers very closely. Oh yeah, I forgot. This browser can navigate through modern websites because, well, it's actually Firefox version 109 to be exact. So you can use this mod as if you're just running a modern Windows installation. Windows Media Player in this mod is version 6.4, different from Windows 98. But that's okay, you can play videos in here, but treat it as if you're using it on the Windows 98, because I don't guarantee it to run as smooth as modern Media Player. Take a look! Yeah, it's quite laggy, maybe because of VMware, or else, I don't know. For the quadrinity of system applications, Calculator, Notepad, WordPad, and Paint do run here, although I don't know why Paint throws an error earlier. Some Windows 98 applications are included in here, take imaging as an example. But I recommend you to view BMP files in here, rather than PNG or anything else, because I'm not sure if the application supports that. Sound Recorder is in here, and despite a warning, it's actually recording. Well, that might be the one and only time I'll ever hear that voice. The legendary phone dialer is in here, although it doesn't run normally from the start menu. You have to manually use Run Dialog to open it. Windows Help is in here, and the reconstruction of it is pretty well done, congratulations! While I'm opening some applications, we can see that the Alt Tab interface is period accurate. But if you look at the taskbar, some applications have thinner borders and gaps in the tasks list. Maybe it's just a bug. Speaking of bugs, I don't know exactly how to explain this, but well, there are several things missing in this mod. If you open the display properties, it only shows the resolution and color settings right there. Where are the backgrounds, screen saver and appearance tabs? Also no games, bummer! And opening the accessibility options is okay, but there is no accessibility folder and programs in the start menu. I wonder why. Well, as for the display properties, you actually need to open it from the control panel. Yes, I don't know, that's just how it works. It will initially throw you around 5 to 6 warnings, but eventually it's there. You can customize the background and screen saver, but don't touch the appearance tab as it will mess up with the caption boxes and other aspects too. This Windows 10 mod surprisingly uses Windows 9X WinVir, which I didn't expect. But at what cost? Well, that's the only WinVir you have. Unlike Windows 98, where you have another WinVir, as I say. Okay, before you comment out, but on the beta wiki, it doesn't say it has to WinVir on Windows 9X. Honestly, I don't know why there are two incorrect versions of WinVir from Explorer and WinVir.exe. It's what already bothering me since I was 15 or so. You can enlighten me about this in the comment section down below, rather than talking crap about my mistake. Come on, not everyone is perfect, and everybody makes a mistake. Back to the video. Yeah, another WinVir, I say. While WinVir reports that it's Windows 98, System Properties instead says that it's Windows 98 2nd Edition version 10.0.19.0.44, which is Windows 10 21H2, or Windows 10 LTSC 2021 to be exact. Oh yeah, one fact that I noticed is that the General tab is the only one is accurate. The Hardware, User Profiles, and Advanced tabs are actually labeled as Device Manager, Hardware Profile, and Performance in Windows 98 respectively. Since this is Windows 10, there are several applications that still uses either the Windows 10 variant or something newer than Windows 98. Starting with Character Map. It's a minor difference, so I'll let that slide. Command Prompt. It doesn't have the style bar below the title bar. That's okay. Task Manager. This one doesn't really matter because I know changing vital system applications is pretty difficult. This applies to MS Config too. Other system applications such as System Restore, Remote Desktop Connections, and Snipping Tool are kept from Windows 10. And remember what I told you earlier about the accessibility lacking in the Start menu? Well, you need to manually invoke them in a Run dialog. That's applied for on-screen keyboard and magnifier. Now I know why the accessibility applications aren't listed in there, because it isn't really faithfully from Windows 98. Despite its obstacles to replicating the Windows 98 look and feel, there are still advantages of Windows 10 features staying in its mod, mainly the task view and virtual desktop features, which I definitely wish Windows included these way earlier. Even though the virtual desktop has no animation, no worries. Windows 10 settings can also be opened by using the Windows I shortcut, but do note that some of the essential customization is locked under the Windows activation. Yes, this copy is not activated, and I think the creator has no intention to sail the sea for the copy. Windows 10 Start menu can be opened by holding Shift while clicking the Start button or pressing the Windows key. Oh yeah, I left out one weird addition. If you try to shut down the mod, you have the option to restart in MS-DOS mode. When you choose the option, it opens up DOSBox X, an MS-DOS emulation program. Well, I don't know how I can say about this. Well, practically it's okay, but technically it isn't restarting. But I'm not declining the feature, duh. The mod you see right now is the creation of Mr. Armor Yoskin, and by looking at the credits there, there are so many programs and tweaks used to make this possible. This is a pretty considerable effort, I admit, and you can start your customization journey this time too, because everybody loves to be creative with Windows, don't ya? Well, probably that's not what Microsoft really wants today from you anyway.